Okay, let's talk about the GED exam and how to increase your chances of passing like right now, immediately. So what can you do right this moment, okay, or within the next few minutes or today to actually increase your chances of passing the GED? So that's gonna be the topic of this video. If you're new to my channel, my videos actually have many, many videos on the GED and other tests and math in general. That's my area of expertise, but I've helped a lot of people out in this particular area. So if you can gain some value from this video, I hope you consider becoming a subscriber. If you do, please hit that bell notification because I'm posting all the time. And before we get going, if you're studying for the GED and you're struggling with math, I have a highly effective, very successful GED math course, math prep course. I'll leave a link in the description of this video if you want to check that out. But let's get into this here. So what can you do like right away to increase your chances of getting your GED? Okay. Now, most of you might be thinking, well, he's going to tell me some secret tip or some shortcut and whatnot. No, I'm not going to tell you anything like that. I wish I could, right? I wish I could say, hey, if you just do this, this is going to give you a real big advantage. However, what I am going to tell you is very, very, very important in, for you to actually hold that GED in your hand, to actually have the experience of completing and passing the GED. So what is that? Basically, you need to show up. You need to show up and take the test. All right, take the test. Now, that seems kind of silly, right? But a lot of people don't get to this point. All right, and I'm going to get into that now. All right, I want to give you some more specific things of what I'm talking about. So, through the years, let me just kind of do a little timeline here like this. I've had the privilege of helping out many people through the years, getting their GED and other exams. And the range of people in terms of their years have spanned anywhere from, say, 18 years old all the way up to, say, 60 plus years old, or people who wanted to go back and get their GED. So somewhere along this path, people have decided they need to go back at their GED. However, I've spoken to many people, especially in older age groups, and I would say maybe like saying or people in their 30s, mid-30s, 40s, etc., that have been putting off getting their GED. But here's the deal. They, people are walking around going, oh, I want my GED, and they're thinking about this for 20 years, okay? Or 10 years, put whatever number you want to put on for yourself. Maybe, let's say you're 22 years old, okay, and you've been thinking about this for 2, 3, 4 years. I mean, it's relative to that number of years, relative to how old you are, is still significant. But literally, I've spoken to many people in their 50s and 60s are like, boy, I got to get my GED. And many of them, probably if not all of them, most of them, have considered getting their GED or thought about it in the past. So they're carrying this with them for years. Okay. And here's how it kind of goes, right? It goes like this. At one point, you're kind of motivated to get your GED and you're like, okay, your energy level goes up. And then you get like a decent job, life happens, and then it just kind of goes down. You stop thinking about the GED, you forget it. And maybe you even say, I don't really need it. Then something happens a couple, 2, 3, 4, 5 years later, and you're like, oop, well, I really should get that GED. I really want to go back to school. I want to get my degree. No, but, da-da. And you kind of do this deal over and over. Many people do that. I'm certain that if you're listening to this video, many of you, if not all of you, can relate to that. And that's human nature. Okay. And it happens, to myself as well in terms of goals and things that I want to get done. You have like a peak motivation, and then, other things get in the way in your life, and what happens? You procrastinate, it gets postponed, you have other priorities come up, and it just, you forget about it, right? And then you start thinking about it again, you have more time, and but, as you go through life, what happens is those peak motivation times here, you're thinking about it. You're thinking, I wanna get my GED. I really need to get started. You spend so much time thinking and not enough time actually doing. Okay. And they call this paralysis by analysis. I don't know if you've heard that phrase, but it's basically you're frozen by overthinking things. Okay. Literally, my best advice to you, and this is where I'm going to give you my little secret for this video, is the following. Don't be one of those people. If you don't have your GED, okay, go take the GED. Even if you don't study, at least you could say you took the GED. So you can't get a GED. Here's the GED test over here, right? You can't get this unless you go try, unless you attempt it, unless you show up and you actually take the exam, okay? So you might be thinking, well, that's like simple enough. That's, that's kind of dumb. You know, this whole idea that that's what this little secret's about. You know, I'm being very honest that the best thing you could do, right, to increase your chances of getting your GED is to schedule it, right? You need to set an actual date and time, okay? And you got to stick this thing like on a big calendar, and you should sign it, like a little personal contract to yourself. And you need to tell your best friends, post it on your social media, hey, on this day and this time, I'm going to be taking a GED. Wish me good luck. Okay. Now, there was I read something a while back. It was pretty, I read a lot of articles about similar to what I'm going to be telling you here. But they've, I think it was in a British health system. They did a study about people trying to get in shape, going to the gym, like New Year's resolution. And they followed two groups of people. And one group of people were like, I'm going to plan on working out 3 times a week at the gym. Okay. So you had one group of folks that said, okay, I'm going to work out 3 times per week at the gym. Okay. So they followed these groups. And then they had another group of people. And it was this. It was something similar. It was, I'm going to work out 3 times a week at the gym, but it was very specific. It was more like along the lines, I'm going to be at the gym at 7:15 a.m. I'm going to leave at 8:30 a.m. and I'm going to be working out on these specific equipment, doing these exercises. It was very, very, very specific. Okay. And these folks here in this group that wrote out their statement in a very specific manner, every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, I'm going to be in the parking lot at 7 o'clock in the gym, working out on this, doing these exercises to this thing. And, you know, they wrote it out in a very specific manner. These folks had like a 90% accomplish rate. They follow through. These folks over here, okay, they were just like average, like really terrible. I think maybe only like 30% of the people followed through, which was basically, you know, like most people, right? They'll say like, hey, I'm going to go, but they never really go, right, to the gym. Kind of the classic New Year's resolution type of thing. So why is that? Well, I think in their study, what they kind of concluded was the more you can write things out, kind of make a self-commitment to yourself, kind of like a doctor's appointment. If you say to yourself, you know, get that little card, like, okay, in 2 weeks, I got to be at the doctor's at 10 o'clock in the morning for my checkup or whatever. Or in 3 weeks, I got to go back to my hairstylist to do, they're going to be doing my hair over again or whatever the case is. And you have very specific appointments. Okay. Just writing that out and put it on the calendar. People, we kind of like, you know, tend to follow those commitments, little, you know, reminders. It's like you take responsibility for it, right? Ownership for it. When you give yourself kind of like a lax kind of goal, you're not going to follow through. So let's get back to the GED. What you should do, okay, you should pick a time, though I would say no more than 1 month away, 1 month to 2 months for most people. Okay, go call today, right? Go call your local, just look up in your local city or whatnot and look for adult education, GED, etc. Call someone up, say, hey, listen, I want to take the GED. Where do I take it? How do I get scheduled, etc. Just start building out an exact time and date you're going to take the GED and then commit to it. Say, okay, how can I sign up? You know, do I need to pay a fee or whatever the case is? Do what you got to do to set that in stone. Now, once you have that, write it out. Okay, write it out, maybe sign it to yourself. Say, I'm going to show up no matter what. Even if I don't study, I'm going to show up and I'm going to fail it, but I am going to show up. Now, obviously, I want you to do more than fail the GED, okay? But you can't even get one unless you show up and take the test. So that's the first thing you can do, and you should do it today, all right? At the latest tomorrow, okay? Unless you're watching this on a weekend, but do it immediately. Set that time. And from there, you can reverse engineer this. Once you have a date and time, you can say, okay, I got 45 days. I need to really get going because I really don't want to waste my money. And I let my family and friends know that I'm going to be taking the GED. They're going to be asking me about it. So give yourself a little bit of accountability. You don't want to be like, yeah, I failed it, that type of thing. Give it your best shot. There's quite a few people that have that I've seen through the years who've taken a GED. Matter of fact, a lot of people. More than once, they'll pass one section or another section. And these are, you know, I love hearing from these folks because they show persistence. A lot of these folks have missed passing the GED by like one point on a particular section, but they don't quit. Okay. And I've had some folks become very discouraged and like, oh, you know, I was just about ready to quit, you know, and I kind of say, do not quit. That's the worst thing you could do. Just keep fighting until you get this done. Now, I have a lot of other videos on the GED on how to make the most of your study time. There's a lot that goes into that. But, you know, that's not going to mean anything. You can be the best study person, okay? It's not going to mean anything unless you actually don't show up and take the test. You have to show up and take the exam, and you need to mentally make that commitment. So I'm not going to berate this point, but I will say this much. This idea of setting very specific goals and accountability is more, you know, it's just goes beyond the GED. You ought to try that in other areas of your life as well. So let's go ahead and just call this a wrap. Okay. Hopefully, you know, you're going to take what I'm saying kind of, you know, seriously, right? Trust me, I'm not trying to waste your time. If you're spending time with me, okay, watching these videos, believe me what I'm telling you, I'm speaking from experience, and I'm trying to give you valuable knowledge. And oftentimes, just because something's simple doesn't mean it's not effective or extremely important and easy, okay, as well, or not easy to do. Like simple things, like, hey, it's simple to do something, but a lot of people can't do simple things because it requires strong habits. That's another topic altogether. But anyways, again, I hope you got something out of this video. I have a lot of other videos that will help you get going to pass your GED. So hopefully you'll subscribe, hit that bell notification. If you enjoyed the video, I definitely appreciate a thumbs up. If you want to take my full GED math prep course, I'll leave the link again in the description. And lastly, leave me some feedback. It's the only way I know how I'm doing, and it gives me ideas on future videos. But with that being said, I certainly appreciate your time. I wish you all the best, and have a great day.